morning. Joyful, joyful, we adore you, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before you, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. Good morning. And let us begin our prayer with the sign of our salvation. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, coming together as God's holy family, and let us now call upon God's love to heal us and to forgive our sins. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whose grace, though sinners, we are made just, and though pitiable, made blessed, stand, we pray, by our works, stand by your gifts, that those justified by faith may not lack the courage of perseverance, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After much debate had taken place, Peter got up and said to the apostles and the presbyters, "My brothers, you are well aware that from early days God made his choice among you, that through my mouth the Gentiles would hear the word of the gospel and believe. And God knows the heart, bore witness by granting them the Holy Spirit, just as he did us. He made no distinction between us and them, for by faith he purified their hearts. Why then are you putting God to the test by placing on the shoulders of the disciples a yoke that neither our ancestors nor we have been able to bear? On the contrary, we believe that we are saved through the grace of the Lord Jesus in the same way as they." The whole assembly fell silent, and they listened while Paul and Barnabas described the signs and wonders God had worked among the Gentiles through them. After they had fallen silent, James responded, "My brothers, listen to me. Simeon, who has described how God first concerned himself with acquiring from among the Gentiles a people of his name, the words of the prophets agree with this, as it is written, 'After this, I shall return and rebuild the fallen hut of David. From its ruins, I shall rebuild it and raise it up again, so that the rest of humanity may seek out the Lord, even all the Gentiles on whom my name is invoked. Thus says the Lord, who accomplishes these things known from of old. It is my judgment, therefore, that we ought to stop troubling the Gentiles who turn to God, but tell them by letter to avoid pollution from idols, unlawful marriage, the meat of strangled animals, and blood. For Moses, for generations now, has had those who proclaim him in every town, as he has been read in the synagogues every Sabbath. The word of the Lord. Proclaim God's marvelous deed to all the nations. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations. Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds. Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations. Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the peoples with equity. Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete." The Gospel of the Lord. In our gospel reading today, Jesus offers and gives us his peace and joy. He clearly tells us that only by remaining steadfast in our faith and remaining in his love, his joy will be in us and our joy might be complete. Today, Jesus speaks about his own joy and peace, a peace that the world cannot give or offer. The joy that he offers us is the joy that will lead us to a new life, salvation. We are asked to remain steadfast in our faith, in our hope, peace, forgiveness, courage, and in our love to one another. When that happens, Jesus promises us that we will receive glory from God and we will be honored by God. His own peace and joy will be in us and our joy will be complete. We always say that the Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. My brothers and sisters, today, Jesus calls us to hear his voice and follow him. May God bless us. With confidence, let us bring before the Lord our prayers for ourselves and for the world. We pray for the bishops throughout the world. May the Holy Spirit continue to animate them in their proclamation of the gospel. We pray to the Lord. For our civic leaders, may the Lord light the pathway for their prudent and just decision-making in service of the common good. We pray to the Lord. For all who struggle with mental illness, may the Lord surround them with a community of loving care and acceptance. We pray to the Lord. For all who have died, may the Lord welcome them with joy into his eternal presence. For recently deceased, we pray for Philip Chavez, Daniel Innocent, Carolina Aguilar, Alejandro Orozco, Blanca Wolfstein, Celedinho Calvino, and for those who have died from COVID-19 virus, we pray to the Lord. That the sick and those preparing for recovery from surgery, for Enedina Clements, Maria Dolores Salazar, Marta Resendiz, Laura Mendoza, Brett Yeomans, Susan Melano, Terry Sordrager, Ray Dickey, Mary Elena Valcon, Maxine Musser, Rogelio Castaneda, Kay Moynihan, Ellie Nelson, Joanne Sarlis, Irina Novikova, and particularly those who suffer from coronavirus, we pray to the Lord. And today's Mass is being offered to pray and to remember for the repose of the soul of Pietrantonio. For him, his family, relatives, and friends, we pray to the Lord. And also we pray for Juan and Ophelia Infante, who celebrate their 48th wedding anniversary today. May God bless them, their family, relatives, and friends, we pray to the Lord. And in silence, let us now add our own petition. We pray to the Lord. Good and gracious God, we trust that you always hear us, and we ask that you answer these petitions in accordance with your will, through Christ our Lord, forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Our sacrifice is ready. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange affected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead. Grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, may we make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took the bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, and with all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs and to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And together we say the prayer that our Lord Jesus Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us now offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace. Peace, peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And let us now pray the prayer of the spiritual communion for our sisters and brothers who are participating in this Mass by watching us from Facebook. And let us remember them in our prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with the heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to a newness of life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. And let us salute our Blessed Virgin Mary. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor body, children, Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, and eyes of mercy toward us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O holy Mother of God. Bendito, bendito, bendito sea Dios. Los ángeles cantan y alaban a Dios. Los ángeles cantan y alaban a Dios. Yo creo, Jesús mío, que estás en el altar. Oculto en la hostia, te vengo a adorar. Oculto en la hostia, te vengo a adorar. Oh, salutaris hostia, qui celi pandis hostium, bella premunt hostilia, da robur vera auxilium. Uni trino che domino sit sempiterna gloria, qui vitam sine termino nobis donet in patria. Amen. Sanctum ergo sacramentum, venerimur cernui, et atticum documentum, novo cedat ritui, present fides supplementum, sensum devectui. Genitori genitoque, laus et jubilatio, salus honor virtu coque, sit et benedictio, procedenti ab utroque, comparsit laudatio. Amen. You have given them the bread from heaven, having all sweetness within it. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of the kingdom where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Counselor. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious Assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints. Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter clave, all in heaven all adoring. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign.